Hello wonderful person, this is Anton, and in this video we're going to be talking about a discovery of a very unusual star that seems to be escaping our own galaxy, and it also seems to be a little bit weird in its composition, mass, and size. And it just so happens that we also found three more similar stars, making this a kind of a phenomenon we didn't really know existed. Let's talk about this and welcome to What the Math. And I wanted to start our discussion right here around the star known as Sirius B. Now this is in the Sirius constellation, and this is a star that's very close to a very famous Sirius A star that's one of the brightest stars in the night skies, but this one you cannot really see very easily because it's a white dwarf. It's actually a pretty small and a pretty dim star, very similar to what our sun will become in roughly around 7 to 8 billion years from now. And just to give you a visual comparison of all of this, here's our sun, here is Sirius A, that's the bright star in the night skies, and right between them, if you kind of squint your eyes, you might see the star I just mentioned. This right here is the very, very dim Sirius B. But the interesting thing about it is that because it's a white dwarf, it's extremely dense and quite massive. It's almost as massive as our own sun, but all of this mass is condensed into this tiny amount. And the star we just recently discovered, whose name is LP40-365, is somewhere in between. Now, it's definitely larger in size than Sirius B, but ironically, it's a lot less massive. As a matter of fact, the mass here is roughly around 14% the mass of the sun, whereas this is almost the same mass as our sun. And this is actually kind of common amongst these so-called white dwarfs. White dwarfs normally decrease in size as they become more massive. So with more mass, they become more dense and smaller in radius. But this particular star is even more unusual because it's much larger in size than typical white dwarfs and way, way less massive than is expected of them. In other words, this right here is a very weird white dwarf. And what's even weirder is this. This is the observation in the last 40 years between 55 and 95, and you can kind of see the motion of this star right here. And though it might not appear like it's moving fast, it's actually moving really fast across the night skies. So fast, as a matter of fact, that it's escaping our galaxy. Its total velocity is approximated at around 546 kilometers per second, which is basically the double of what our own sun moves at. And this is beyond the escape velocity of our galaxy, so this particular star is going to be leaving our galaxy in the next few million years. But it's not alone. We've discovered three other stars that are very similar. The paper that was published in June of 2019 talks about four stars in total that they refer to as these partly burned runaway stellar remnants. In other words, they refer to them as these sort of unusual white dwarfs that experienced what seems to be a supernova and are burned by something and are now on the way out from our galaxy. But the thing is, these runaway stars are not really unusual. We've discovered quite a lot of them in the last few years. There's actually dozens of them going in and out of our galaxy, so they're sort of typical. And most of them are usually kicked out of the galaxy either by moving too close to the supermassive black hole in the center, or by being thrown out of the system through a supernova of their partner. Usually, if one of the stars explodes, the partners will then start moving really, really fast across the galaxy due to all of this force that was created. But here's the thing about this particular discovery. It seems that none of this really happened to this particular star, because even though it's experienced the actual supernova, it seems that the supernova was from the star itself. And this is where it gets really interesting, because we just discovered a new type of a star and a new type of an object. From what we can see by observing this star and from seeing all of the matter around it and unusual dust formations and the presence of oxygen and silicon, but not hydrogen and helium, we can sort of estimate that it definitely experienced a supernova itself. So this star that was maybe around several masses of the sun was about to turn into a white dwarf, and so it started to condensed and it started to get smaller and smaller, but then as it was about to go through supernova and possibly turn into a neutron star or maybe even a black hole, instead the supernova was somehow imbalanced and a part of this star, and specifically the core of this star, managed to survive and then escaped the actual supernova, the actual remnants of all of this, and became its own object flying through the galaxy really fast. And as I mentioned, there are four of these we've discovered, so this seems to be not a very uncommon event. So what's left here is basically a white dwarf, or a core of a star, that was released or sort of kicked out of its own system by its own supernova, and the actual remnant is still there. It's not a neutron star, it's not a black hole, it's basically this tiny, super small, somewhat light white dwarf that we've never really seen before, making this possibly also the smallest white dwarf ever detected. And this directly relates to the idea of the so-called supernova known as Type 1AX. These supernovae have been speculated for the past couple of years because we've seen something that may have resembled their appearance, and we always thought that these supernovae do occur, we just couldn't really find the result of them. And the main idea behind these supernovae is that they're typical white dwarf supernova, where the white dwarf actually survives and doesn't necessarily completely get destroyed. A part of it stays as a star and starts traveling across the galaxy. And several studies have tried to kind of put the actual limits on these type of supernova and what they produce, but until now we didn't really know what exactly could be producing them or what the result of these supernova are. But with these four discoveries, four stars that were just found, we are now pretty certain that this is kind of what happens when these supernova occur. They seem to be not very rare, and they also seem to produce these unusual white dwarfs. And the scientists behind this paper expect that by the end of the Gaia mission, which was responsible for discovering these stars to begin with, we'll find roughly around 20 or so of these objects that are going to be traveling across the galaxy, possibly fast, possibly not so fast. We don't really exactly know what to expect yet, but we're pretty sure that there's going to be more of these discovered in the next few years, by 2022, when the Gaia mission is over. So in other words, what this might suggest is that our galaxy is probably full of these unusual, very tiny, very insignificant white dwarfs traveling really fast across the space, but also going into the intergalactic space. And assuming that these supernova and these objects are not very rare, in other words, assuming that these white dwarfs are created pretty frequently, this might suggest that the intergalactic space is actually filled with these objects. Because don't forget, the white dwarfs, they can survive for a really long time. A typical white dwarf can actually stay like this for billions and even trillions of years before it turns into a black dwarf. So intergalactic space might be actually filled with these objects. Because once again, white dwarfs are the actual end product of vast majority of stars. And so once we actually have powerful enough telescopes, we might be able to look into the abyss of intergalactic space and maybe even find more of these objects moving across the skies. Relatively dim, of course, it's very hard to see them, but nevertheless, they might contribute to quite a huge amount of matter out there in space that we never really thought about. But anyway, until we discover more about the unusual supernova known as Type 1AX, or these unusual white dwarfs that don't really have a designation yet, that's really all I wanted to mention in the video. Check out the papers I mentioned in the description below, and subscribe if you still haven't, share this video with someone who loves learning about space and sciences, come back tomorrow to learn something you may have not known before, and maybe even consider supporting this channel on Patreon because it does help me quite a lot. I'll see you tomorrow, space out, and as always, bye bye.